iCon people. It's the second year that I've been at iCon. I've noticed a couple of interesting things, like Magic players get very pissed off when they give people like me a card that says Magic, Judge, and I walk past and go, "Well, it's a copy." Somebody, I'm wearing the tag, the guy comes up to me and says, very cool. First one too, it's very weird. I wanted to play Call of Cthulhu again this year, and I dig the fact that somebody was very mean and walked enough to create horror role playing. For those of people who are out of town who have driven on our freeways, it's more than enough training for you.
Speed bumps
in traffic circles here, so people from the Free State, namely me, feel at home. I'm originally from the Free State, I'm not from here.
We're sorry for you.
You're probably really surprised. I walk upright and I'm not afraid of fire. It's like northern part of the Free State, a small town called Belco, which is known for traffic circles and not much else. Where people ask me where I'm from, there's some people that from Joburg, if you say you're from the south, I'm more like South Central. So our Dutchman driving Hiluxes with hydraulics. Serious multicolored knee-high socks going, oh. Yay, so cool. Roughly translated, thing that says, "Greetings, foreigner, what are you doing?" Germany's supposed to be this hardcore place, but as soon as there's somebody who doesn't have a short back and sides haircut, picture it. It's Alan, Laura, and myself, and Ben walking through, and just for once, I'm not the one getting the weird looks. Is there anybody who's ever, like, in our particular world, like, role-playing and comedy and, like, living in Germany in general? We all get that look, especially when you go to San Francisco, and you know what look I'm talking about, the look of... A while ago, the question was asked of me, you know, the whole superhero thing, it's very much an American and a British thing. Although, of course, British superheroes, they're the very proper ones. The French, they've generally got bad attitude ones. Show up and kill you with bad service. That is my power. I would pay money to see Batman pull into Hillbrow on a Sunday. You see him pull in with a Batman, I'll be like, mm. Chips on it. Quick, Robin, for the Batcave.
Where's my car?
Five cars on the train. Name understand. Ma, Volvo, but I like what you did with the Max. Just a little bit of chrome. Anybody in Cape Town near the flats, you got the car, come back, Batmobile's gone, has been chrome, fucking cool sound system.
Yeah, that jet engine was in the way, we took it out, and there was plenty of space for about 4 amps and about 20 minutes.
What he has to do now is just turns the subwoofers facing backwards and goes... The machine gun had a nice touch, but we didn't think you had enough firepower, so we put in 4 rocket launchers and a nuke. On the upside, if you need to take a photograph, fuck, you've got a bloody big flash. Basically, once again, you guys, thank you so much for allowing us. Still would be outsider in. I'd like to leave you with the basic rules that were given me about how to play Cthulhu. These are rules that I've recited many people, but how it basically says it. Well, if you're going to play, just don't be the first person into a room. Don't be the last person. Don't be the middle person. If there's a glass of water, don't drink it. If there's a book, don't fucking read it. If there's a switch on the wall, don't touch it. So what if it's dark? Yes, but if you switch it on, the monsters can see. Most important rule. Just because you, one of the most important rules, just because you have a gun doesn't mean it's going to fucking work. First scenario I had, this is Graham Kane being the DM, and he says, right, you switch on this machine and you wake up in hell. I'm like, oh, that's convenient. That saves me that trip. He said, jeez, I was going to take 4 grams of cocaine.
And
I'm going to
be a sick module writer.
Oh, yes.
Yes, it was written by Greg Holliman. They told me that Greg writes modules were based on the simple principle of, and they all fucking died. And they all go insane and they die. Or they all go and die and then they get resurrected and then they go insane. So the most important rule that I was told about Call of Cthulhu is no matter what happens, no matter if they did it in India. You guys are making up your own jokes. Indian people go, yes, Lanny, we get you in a fucking lot later. And they're like, this one when we call the mattress, we call discount sailor. I tell you what, Lanny, I gave you a special deal about the and I got a red pill here, it's on sale together for 40 rand. And I throw on a DVD, you've got to fucking see to believe. Two things I was wondering about. First off, in the entire history of fighting the Smith agents, they always said, I've seen long, empty hole clips at them and hit nothing but air. And I'm thinking, well, fuck, try aiming. This one's too stupid to kill. My feeling is, in the entire history of fighting the Smith agents, has no one ever thought of using a shotgun. At some point, the player's going to be like, just 5 guys with shotguns, dodge this. The thing that I like the most is that the Matrix proved to me that if machines do take over everything, if computers finally control the planet, if you look at the internet and you're like, yeah, this is coming true, if it finally does happen that machines control everything, at least we won't have to worry about Microsoft and Windows anymore. Special Windows keyboard control alt delete. And the reason being is that if the Matrix ran on Windows, every fucking few hours the sky would flicker and change color. Doors wouldn't work like a window. Your car would back out of the driveway and fuck off a grocery. And every now and again a big silver bar would appear across the sky. The Matrix has performed an illegal. Matrix does run on Windows. I mean, they've already had to reload the fucking thing 5 times. That's good. That's good. Very good.